The song, the opening song, was called The Neighbors by St. Vincent. Also a very appropriate song for the game, dealing with themes like mood swings, not quite knowing your place, and the way everyone just thinks of you for being a weird person. Yep, that St. Vincent, one edgy gal, but she's a great songwriter. Really good. All right, Night in the Woods. So I don't know how long part four is, or the epilogue for that matter, but I'm going to do my damnedest to finish it tonight. I don't have to work tomorrow. I do have a doctor appointment in the morning, but we'll see how it goes. Can you hear me okay over the game? It's probably the only stream in a while that I've been invested in. Well, I'm glad that this was the one. This is a very... what's the word I'm looking for? It's a very good game to get invested in. It kind of draws you in. Loud and clear. They're fairly short compared to the other parts. Okay. Yeah. Let me just get my controller going. I'm going to be sad when this is over. I'm going to be very sad. I want to play another game like it when I'm done. But I'm thinking I'm going to finish this. Try to finish up Zelda. Try to finish up Resident Evil 7, maybe. In VR. And then I'm thinking about streaming the two Nier games back-to-back. And then Persona 5 in the beginning of April, which I still haven't decided if I'm going to stream it or not. We'll see. I could replay it to see the Greg events. I could. Alright, this is the beginning of part 4. Nice. Yep. I barely remember how to play this. It's like riding a bike. I play this game in my head when I'm falling asleep. I like to go over the plots of books I've read. Oh, look at the smarty. I try to remember every place I've ever been. In order. Wow. Am I gonna go for all endings in both Nier games? Probably not, unfortunately. I probably should, but I don't have that kind of time. Alright, well... What? I'm in control of B. I don't see anyone out there. Just wait. He'll be back. Still... Oh, so they're keeping guard. And the cops?
We called. They don't care.
That's it?
Sir, you say you saw a man outside? Sir, that's not illegal.
Getting dark earlier.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Yeah, exactly. So no word from her parents?
Nope.
That's bad, right?
Yep.
Yep. Thanks, guys. We'll go this way. Oh. I'm so tired. I could, like, curl up on their bed. There's, like, a whole living area under there. Can I play some Demon Tower? Nope. Did I hear about Steven Hillenburg? I don't even know who that is. So, no, I didn't. Let's talk, Germ. I played this until I broke one of the sticks. That's harsh. It was a stressful time, senior year. I remember. Sorry about your mom. Thanks. Aw. Germ, he's more sensitive than he appears. Just went out with a few college buddies on the way home. I got a flat tire, first one. Glad to get home and see my new favorite streamer. Aw, Lucid. Well, I hope the flat tire at least was less stressful than you thought it would be, right? Like, it went smoothly? The changing and stuff? This game had a great soundtrack. Very high school summer.
I listen to, like, half the bands on it. We're going to see the Blank Tones in a few days. Or we were. I don't know.
He is the creator of SpongeBob. Did he die? He got sick. I just googled it. Oh. I never really got into SpongeBob too much. Angus, so... Wait, why did it say his name? What? Want some brownies? I'm making brownies. And...
Yeah?
Maybe lasagna.
Brownie?
I like both of these things. I think I'm doing lasagna. I found one in the freezer.
Why all the food?
Need to eat. Everyone needs to eat.
Aren't you, like, scared and worried?
Good dinner makes everyone feel better. Someone's gotta take care of you.
Thanks, Angus. You're extremely good.
Oh, no more than anyone else.
Oh, Angus.
He has ALS. Oh, no. That's terrible. Well, if there's anyone in chat who SpongeBob meant a lot to them, means a lot to them, my thoughts are with you. My thoughts are with the creator. That's a bummer.
So the guy you saw in the woods at Possum Jump?
Yep.
Were those guys like that guy?
Yep, sorta. He had a hat. I need to defrost a lasagna. Or do I? Do you cook it frozen? No, dum-dum. Angus means well, but he can't even cook frozen lasagna.
Guys, this is a bad situation.
Yep.
Yep.
Yes, him.
Wait, everybody, shut up.
Probably just me. Oh, shit.
What?
I heard it, too.
Seriously, what?
There's someone standing outside the door.
What? Everyone be very quiet.
Oh my god.
What? Hell, the second this sequence started, Steam started to download something, except the progress bar is like way off to the side. Everything's all glitched out and weird. I don't like it. Oh no. Next thing I know, chat's gonna start glitching out too. Captain Crunk, 100 bits, thank you. Yeah, I don't know what happened to May. I don't know, did they leave her all by herself? I assume she escaped. They brought her to the Upside Down. Is her arm gone? Oh shit, it might be. I did just start Mythos. It's all the mailboxes, but no houses. Oh, she stopped. Oh no, May.
God is here. In this room. I believe that. Times like this, we can call out and know that our cries are heard. While we're here, maybe someone would like to say something about May. That'd be nice.
May is a good girl. She and I explored the stars, and she loved to hear about them.
I'm sorry. She can't be dead. No,
it is impossible.
It can be difficult. Anyone else?
I've always known May as the kid down the street. A little younger than me, but tough.
Oh wait, no, this is Selmer's. I thought it was the crocodile talking.
I've been through it in the past couple of years. Addiction, jail, rehab, divorce, and... I just think it's not fair. that May of all people should have trouble. Where's the God in that? Where's the higher power? It's all a bunch of bullshit.
Thank you, Selma. I mean, it's clearly a eulogy, but I think it's misdirection. I don't think she's actually dead. But looking at her body, doesn't look like it's breathing. It's tough to tell. Thinking no one's bodies are breathing. Anyone else?
I'll say something. May Borowski's always been a menace, and I called the police on her more than once. I hope she wakes up and learns a lesson. That's all I got to say.
Okay.
Thank you, William. I'll speak up.
Go ahead.
May was a daughter to all of us on the block.
Speak for yourself.
Sometimes folks in the wrong place at the wrong time. I hope we find out what exactly happened to her.
Oh, we know. Her friends told us.
Yeah, they were out in the woods that night, down the end of Center Ave, and someone was out there hunting illegally, and they got shot at, and May fell, and...
She must have fallen off a million things a million times. All it takes is landing the wrong way one time, and...
Oh, well, I hope she wakes up and tell us all about it. See if she remembers who done it.
Yeah, I think it's a coma.
I'm sure she...
Or May is imagining it. Oh no, no fucking way. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. What's happened to this one?
Do we know you? Are you here to clean up?
Nah, supposed to be fixing a door.
In here?
Nope. Okay, so she's gonna be fine. For today, leastways.
What?
What? Who are you? He was in the very beginning of the game, too. Janitor.
The house is gone.
May!
Oh, thank God. What did you say, May?
It's dead.
What's dead, honey?
May, honey.
Everything.
Surprise, it was all a dream. Oh, okay. What? Oh, tree is blocking me. Okay. I just noticed her feet slide a bit when she walks. Oh no. That's gonna bug me. It's like she's ice skating. Can't jump on the fence anymore. Mm-mm. Oh, this was May making their way up to Angus's place, I guess. They're waiting for her. And the sound they heard was May making her way up. What's over here, though? Anything over here? Nope. Oh, I have to walk all the way back. Damn my curiosity. No, don't tell me. Don't tell me what's happening if you know. I don't want to know. That's a blatant spoiler.
Oh my god. B? Oh my god. May? Holy shit, it's May!
It me.
You came back to life!
I don't think she was dead.
Pizza party!
I'm feeling woozy. You should lie down.
You can sleep in our bed.
I feel weird about that. How about the couch?
Do I have to stop playing?
No, the sound is good.
Her mom said it's okay to keep her here. I'll drive her home later.
So she just, like, wandered out of her house?
Yeah, and all the way here.
Jeez.
Lucky she didn't pass out somewhere out there.
I sure hope she's alright.
Mm-hmm.
Both of you, shh.
So how well do you know this guy?
We order pizza, what, twice a week?
At least.
From out by the highway now since Possibilities closed down.
I thought you two were trying to save money.
What?
Don't police our lifestyle, B.
Okay, well, just as long as we're sure the delivery guy is safe.
I could spot him through the keyhole.
If it's not him, we'll turn off the light. And I guess hide here until we die.
Alright, as long as there's a plan.
May is such good friends. Hello?
Look who's awake.
It's him. It's the pizza guy.
Pizza's here.
Meow. Pizza.
Oh, I can't take their pizzas.
So what happened? We called the cops. Your aunt and some guy fished you out of the woods.
You were like in a coma.
Did you die?
Nah, just took a very long nap.
Nice.
Yeah, nice.
My crest. Oh. I had this dream. Or, like, a vision. Or I time traveled. I don't know. I'm like in and out of consciousness.
Can you not eat?
You should eat.
I don't know if I can.
Sorry, Mom. You scare us to death, honey.
Sorry, Mom.
Well, we'll come pick you up.
No, it's cool. I'm just gonna sleep here.
B is there?
B is here.
Okay.
I'll be back in the morning.
Have B drive you home.
I will.
May.
I know.
Give us a call if you need to come home.
I will. Love you, Mom.
Love you too, sweetie.
You want a brownie?
Nah, can't really eat right now. Like, I'd puke, but there isn't anything in there. So I'd, like, puke my actual guts out.
Oh, right. You need your guts.
For the moment, at least.
Yeah, I was hoping the game had more of those, like, pizza-grabbing segments, like those little mini-games. Because they were so good at breaking up the pace. The early game had a lot of them, but as the game went on, they kind of dropped off a bit.
Dude, wow, weak, huh?
You could say that.
When we get out of this...
I don't know if we're getting out of this.
Well, even if we don't, and we're ghosts, we should hang out more.
Deal. Aww. He regrets the fact that we didn't hang out with him much over the course of the game. What even was that game?
Werewolf Shreddanar 3.
Wow, I played this at Casey's house, like, years ago.
I played it yesterday at home.
Cool. Germ's there because Germ's a cool dude. Even if he's more of an acquaintance than a friend, he's still clearly a good dude, so.
They've got Wi-Fi.
Nice. It's like we're a real deal place. Wait, I don't know why I read it that way. It's like we're a real place, at least within range. I don't even have a phone because of this place. It's the 1800s here. Hey, May? Yeah. I'm really glad you're not dead. Me too. Yeah. 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 Is there anything else to do? I don't know if you can, Lucid. I think you can. Nah, I don't think there's anything else to do. I guess I could check the computer real quick. Maybe it will let me play Demon Tower! Nope, no Demon Tower. Can we all hit the sack? Cool. I'll be right out. Hey kids, can we do lights out now? I'm gonna drop over.
Yeah, dude.
Sounds good. See y'all tomorrow. You sure it's safe for you to leave? None of this got anything to do with me. No weirdos following me around. Oh, right. See ya. Bye, Germ. Later, Germ. Germ just does his own thing. I want a Germ DLC. I want to know what's going on in that little head of his. Do you know why I beat down Andy Cullen 6 years ago? No. We weren't talking then, and I thought it'd be weird to bring it up now, and I was playing this video game. You were, like, dating ghosts or something. Okay. I was really into it. Played it, like, 24/7. Till this one afternoon, and suddenly, like, something broke. Broke? It was just, like, pixels. The characters on screen, I felt like I knew them. They weren't people anymore, they were just shapes. And their lines were just things someone had written down. They never existed. They never had feelings. They never would exist, either. And it felt so sad. Like, I just lost these real people. This whole thing we had, it was just me, alone. And like that realization, like, dumped out of the screen and into real life. Went outside in the tree out front. I looked at it every day, and it was a friend outside the window. Now it was just a thing. Just a thing that was there. Growing and eating and just being there. Like, all this stuff I felt about the tree was just in my head. And there was some guy walking by, and he was just shapes, just like this moving bulk of stuff. And I cried, because nothing was there for me anymore. It was all just stuff. Stuff in the universe. Just dead. Wow. That's... huh. And the next day was that softball game, and Andy was the pitcher when I was up, and he was just shapes too. Just lines someone wrote. Nothing, like nothing in there. And I was so scared and angry and just, I don't know. Before I knew it, I was on top of him, smashing his face in with the baseball bat. Just shapes. Red shapes all over the grass. Oh my God, May. Have you talked to anyone about this? After it happened, they made me go to therapy with Dr. Hank. Oh God, he's the worst. And he made me start a journal. A journal? Yeah, he kind of just said it would be able to help. It would help to be able to get my thoughts down. Did it help? Kinda, sorta. But since this whole thing happened, when I'm alone in a new place, it's all shapes. Like back at the softball game, I was doing fine at college for a while, but I couldn't make friends. I was just afraid of being outside or around people alone. And there was this statue of, like, the founder of something. A really shitty statue, like all rusty metal, and it was these shapes, and he was pointing down at me. I was so scared. I didn't leave my dorm room. I either didn't eat, or I ate entire pizzas at once. I downed cough syrup just to sleep all the time. And finally I got up the courage to leave. I came home, where everything was fine, where I knew everyone, and it wasn't just dead shapes watching me. Jeez. Something broke in my head, in my life. I don't mean to be like, whatever, but it sounds like you're suffering from some serious stuff. And like, I can help you find some help for it? Dr. Hank already tried. I think Dr. Hank should stick to family medicine and dentistry, and the half dozen other things he does, and maybe leave the mental health services to someone else. Like, there are such things as depression and anxiety and, like, I don't know what you're going through. It exists. Your buddy 89, thank you so much. I thought when I came home, I felt so safe here. Everything made sense for a few days. And then all this. And. Shh. It's gonna be okay. Thank you, Captain Crunk. We'll figure this out. I'm so scared. I know. We're all scared. But we're gonna make it. You should just get some sleep. Hi. Hey there, Easy D. How are you doing? Uh-oh. Where are you going, May? Don't tell me you're leaving. No, May. What are you doing, May? Bye, guys. Love you. No, May. The hole in the center of everything. Hey, Skellabum. Oh, please, May. What are you doing? This is the worst idea, May. She's going for a night in the woods. She just falls through a cigarette in her house. That's not safe. Yeah, that's super dangerous. Oh, shit. Nope. I'm going back. I'm going to go to the bridge. The bridge looks safer. Yep. Yeah. So much safer. Right? Right? Is it going to stop me? Can't stop me. It's actually letting me go. Damn, I wonder how far it'll let me go. No, going back, I tried it. How far did it let you go? The worst part is the further I go, the further I have to walk back. But I'm too curious. Oh, that's probably the part where it stops. It's like you waste all the time you want. Oh my god, I have to walk so far back now. Now it's too late. It's just a invisible wall. I need to see this for myself. I've gone in this far. Curiosity has ruined me. This is how I play games, guys. This is why I'm embarrassed to stream stuff like this. Because I get in situations like this. It's never too late. No, it is. It is too late. Oh, there it is. That's the start. Oh, it really is just an invisible wall. Sunk cost fallacy. That's true. That is a huge fallacy, and I fall prey to it. Well, time to walk back. If you turned around, the ghost you was right there, it'd be great. Yeah, that would have been awesome. Well, let's trek on back. I have a feeling if they were gonna do the invisible wall route, they should have just put it sooner to save you some time. Now the slow walk of shame. Yep. Important gaming experiences. This is how I play video games. The devs didn't expect people to walk all the way back. The thing is, I didn't make a connection between where I was and where I had started there. I wanted to see everything that was between it. We play games very similarly. Yeah, I need to try it. That's why I jump down every pit, you know? See what the developers accounted for and what they didn't. Almost there. Okay. And victory lap. I know what you're thinking. You're like, that was a good one, KY. He's not going to actually do it. Well, let me tell you.
No, just kidding. And then I lost all of my viewers, all of my subs. What are you? Are you actually a ghost? Or just some guy? Consortium. I'll have to check that out, EZD. What is this thing in my head? Are you doing this? Why is this happening to me? Talk! Fine, let's do this. And, oh, it won't even let me go back now. It'll only let me go forward. Oh, damn! Arrowed. Fucking Greg has a crossbow. Boom. Get away from her, you piece of shit. You're outnumbered, asshole. Ah, you shot me. And we can all use both of our arms. I will personally disassemble you.
Whoa, jeez, B.
Ah! Ooh. It's gotta be Casey. It's clearly Casey.
You okay?
Where did... Well, he's wounded. Sounded like he went back up to the mine.
Yeah, what do we do?
Follow him, I guess.
Y'all wait here. I'll go. Don't be like that, May.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Anyway. If he's up in the mine, we might be able to corner him and
tie him up.
Or something.
Can you walk, May? I think so. Might be a little slow. I'll help you if you need it. Thanks, big guy.
Alright. Let's go do something real stupid.
Gate's open.
Oh, jeez.
What?
We could block it shut or something.
Yeah, they just flat out ignored her. And I was kind of, I think that was great that they didn't have the big dramatic, like, no, I insist I go alone.
And they're like, but May, we're your friends.
You know, they just skipped it. They ignored her, and then she knew that it was, you know, that she couldn't change her minds.
Aw, dang. You're right.
No. I have to go down there. Well then.
Looks like all of his friends are gone.
Just one guy.
Just one guy.
Just one something.
Bang bang!
Well, this isn't dangerous or anything.
Nothing to be scared of down there. Just a party.
And not too late to throw ourselves in the traffic instead.
Dude, Greg's got a crossbow. They'll be fine. Looks like he took the elevator down. So much for the element of surprise. He's gonna hear us coming a mile away.
Are you sure we want to do this?
Yeah, May. You sure?
Guys, I don't know if you understand.
He's in my head.
I can't function like this. Everything is dying or dead already.
I don't know what's gonna happen down there.
Okay, then. We'll come out of this together.
Oh, that thing looks old.
They haven't used this mine in, like, a lot of years. Generations, even.
Are you our tour guide now?
We have the Possum Springs tourism pamphlets at the shop. And I get bored. This isn't a brochure.
Well, here we are.
May, you okay? I have my inhaler.
No, I'm fine. It's like something huge is on top of me. I mean, technically you're not wrong.
Is it like asthma? That's how asthma is.
It's not asthma, big guy. But thanks.
Shh. I heard something down there. You're gonna be okay, May?
Yeah, I'm alright. We should be quiet.
Yeah, gotta save up for the screaming later.
And right. Part two, here we go. Keep it going. Oh, yeah. Aw. Nope, just kidding. Dude, stream's been on for 40 minutes already? Holy fuck. Door.
Tunnel. Whatever.
Here we go. Lucid Dreamcast, just subscribed. Thank you so much, Lucid. I really appreciate it.
Ah, jeez.
What is this place?
Looks like a church or something.
And, like, junk?
Oh, God. Oh, God.
There's a pentagram in the background. What is it?
It's here. Oh, God.
What is it?
I don't know, but it's here. It's through there.
Very clever.
I know you're in here. Say something. Well, how about this? Take a couple more steps forward if you want to die.
Show yourself.
Yeah, asshole, we're like 5 times scarier than you.
Uh-oh. Yep. Let's say, in before a lot of people.
They're there. They're right there. I'm gonna kill them.
Eid, you'll do no such thing. It's out of your hands now.
He shot me.
Then I'd say we're even. Little girl got shot the other night.
Yeah, sorry about that.
You're apologizing?
It was a bad call. I'm sorry.
It's okay. It didn't actually
hit me, so... Wait, what the... Who are you?
Bunch of old boys doing their damnedest to protect their own and their neighbors.
Then why are you trying to kill me?
Kill you?
Nobody's gonna kill you.
All of you are part of this town. By family relation or just by being hard workers.
Contributors. Okay, so we could just leave?
Well, he brought you down here for a reason, and he is not gonna let you leave until he's had his say.
Well, he's already got an arrow through the shoulder. I don't think he's gonna be having much say in whatever.
Wait, so you think that I'd...
He kidnapped that kid at Harvest. He's been in my head somehow. I'm always tired. Constant headaches. He's been following me. Following all of us. He...
Oh, ho, 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 little girl. You don't know what this is, do you?
What? Oh, God. I've seen this. Or I've felt it.
Was Ed Scudder and Jim Dorney who found it, 20 years back or so, after the West Mine closed out past Brittle. Vest Schumacher, last supervisor, was out there when the company locked off the entrance, carved his initials and date on the door. Then you got this mine, the old one. Not even a proper mine, big hole, copper. Abandoned, shoot, long before any of us were born. Too close to water. And that water was poison. When the first settlers came out here, that old spring used to be right above where we were standing. Right where we're standing. That water dried up. 1992 or so, some men from West Mine came back here to try bootlegging. Practically built a new elevator, got the main tunnel cleared. Never found no coal, just dug deeper and deeper. Till Ed busts through that wall and finds this place. And Jim walks right into that hole and never hits bottom. Ed calls down to Jim. Jim don't answer. But someone else does. I know you heard that voice, girl. In dreams and in waking times. So what brought you down here?
What is it?
Black goat. Not even black like the color. Black like the space between the stars. He's down there in that hole. Looking up at us right now. He don't talk to you. He sings.
Why would you just do something a hole in a cave told you to?
You gotta understand. In those days, it was the end of the world. Jobs gone. Our kids were leaving. Government didn't care, only wanted our votes. Just putting in more regulations, sending our jobs overseas, spending our taxes on lazy people and ignorant immigrants, while we worked ourselves to death.
Here we go. Goddamn, I hate this crap, you old dipshits.
You finished?
Yeah, sure.
We prayed and prayed up at the church. But when Ed Scudder came back down here and listened, he got answers back.
Answers?
Ed explained it to a few folks and they didn't believe it. But he was persuasive. He had the glimmer.
The glimmer? Once you take a shine into, it rubs off on you. You can do things.
I never seen it. But they said Ed could walk through walls.
Okay.
After Ed talked us into all this. After that first time, after we picked one out, well, not only was the town old and stable, but it was almost like we were getting younger, and money came, too. Still, a few of us left from back then.
Picked.
First one was Tom Turner, who, believe you me, was a bastard. Just pure trash. We got him down here, and in the hole he went. The next week, flowers blooming all over the hills.
You throw them in the hole? They're
feeding him. He's hungry like you wouldn't believe. Every few months or so, he starts singing. And it's someone's turn to find someone. Oh, wow.
Ellipses. Think I'm gonna be sick.
We never pick no one who's gonna be missed. That's a solid rule. Drifters, drunks, delinquents.
You've been...
Oh, God. Oh, no.
This is totally Hot Fuzz. That's what this is. Someone needs to make a Night in the Woods Hot Fuzz mashup. I will commission you. Contact me after the stream.
Casey? Hartley, kid. All he was gonna contribute to society set the bunch of kids grown up with no dad, with what's a rap sheet a mile long, before whatever sad end he'd wind up at. We did him a favor.
You killed Casey?
Oh my God. We don't use that word. You know he was taking up business with his cousin, right? You know what happened to his cousin? Burned alive when his little trailer lab exploded. They had to wear hazmat suits when they cleaned him up. That's where Casey was headed.
You killed Casey.
You want to act like we didn't do him and this whole town a favor?
Oh God, Casey's been down here the whole time. His parents put up posters.
Maybe they should have cared more about him before it came to this.
Which one of you did it?
Greg.
He was my friend!
Alright now, throw it down.
Throw it down right now, or I will shoot.
What if I get you first? Bolt sticking right out of your eye. Bang! Bang!
You brought guns down here? Dangerous this far out in the woods at night. Basic safety. One sec, I need some water. Okay.
Hi. Hi.
Throw it down here, son. Throw it down, son. Don't make this our time.
Greg. Dang it.
Oh. You're monsters. None of this. None of this is happening.
We're not monsters. We do it because we love our home. As long as we keep doing this, Possum Springs survives. Things can get better. These mines are gonna be humming again someday. Old mills puffing smoke. You kids don't understand that. We lost what our world was built around. Used to be you provided for a family, bought a house. Now you're stocking shelves at the grocery store. Kids leaving more than they're staying. No opportunity here. Old people dying, houses left empty. You ever seen that? A home become a tumbled in pile of wood and plaster? A job become a burned out brick box or a hole in the ground? But we can change that. We can put this place back together. Where it won't be just
shapes. I'm gonna die down here.
Don't you fucking dare, May.
Why are you telling us all this?
Because we're getting old. And even with the fringe benefit of good health, we need new blood to carry this on when we're gone.
Really? You're like pitching us on this? Were any of you even miners back in the day? Any of you hurting now, financially like? Or is this just some big costume party murder club? For someone shitty boss who's afraid of dying.
That don't matter.
It kinda does. It does.
This is real bad.
This is insane.
Let's see, why should we help you? Why shouldn't we just call the cops?
And say, what? You saw some men you can't identify in an abandoned mine behind a locked gate? And an elevator that won't run? You saw a hole?
Okay, fine. Why should we help you?
Because if no one is here to do this, you remember that flood a few years back? You remember the blizzard of 2010? That's what happens. And beyond that, the jobs never come back. The kids never come back.
Another movie this reminds me of is called, I think it's called We're Still Here. Man, I gotta look it up. Someone look up and let me know if that's the movie.
Everything crumbles. Possum Springs bleeds to death. And soon we'll all be dead. And this town will just be fields and trees.
I seen it.
I know you have. I'll understand if you need some time to think it over.
So we can leave?
No one's gonna stop you. But understand that you don't know who we are out there. But we know who you all are.
Ain't fair they get to leave and I probably got permanent damage.
Shut it, Ide!
You don't know a thing about what he wants. What he is.
Ide, I swear to God.
Let's go.
Yeah, let's seriously get out of here.
Two couples. Yeah, no, exactly, Jethro. That movie with, like, the psychic couple. Yeah, that's what it reminds me of. I think it's called, yeah, We Are Still Here. That's what this reminds me of.
Son, you leave that crossbow.
What? Why?
Well, I could bullshit you, but the truth is, I just don't trust you.
Fine, whatever, it's a piece of shit anyway.
I can't move, you guys.
I'll carry you.
I have no idea what to even think about any of this.
It's just horror.
That's not a word you get to use too often.
It's all I've got left. Like, everything else in my head is gone.
Let's get out of here fast.
I don't know if I...
Shh. Talk later.
Old Stefan here. I've not seen Jesus Camp, no.
Okay, I'm gonna have to put you down for a sec, okay?
Yeah, one thing I want to point out, since politics got brought up briefly in the chat, these towns, I mean, the cults don't exist. I mean, maybe somewhere, in a few remote places they might, but the towns like this, you know, where entire industries got shut down, people lost their jobs and their homes, all the young folk moving away to do college and other bigger things, just destroying the economy of these little towns, these exist. These are real towns. These are legitimate concerns, you know, between regulations shutting down businesses entirely, just tons of regulations, and work being outsourced to immigrants and all sorts of things. These actually happen. These are legitimate concerns that that those people have. So keep that in mind. I mean, that's not imaginary. It's not something that's made up or in a cartoon. They exist.
Okay, I'm gonna have to put you down for a sec, okay?
Okay. Like, why do you think that Obama and Trump both campaigned so hard in the Rust Belt and promised change to everybody? And why do you think that those same people voted for those presidents, you know?
So, Casey.
Yeah.
Aye.
Yeah.
And for what?
I think I get it.
Wow, really?
Too tired to explain it right, but, like, they lost what they thought was gonna happen, which was what had happened, like, a long time ago, or how they remember or, like, picture it, and things it gave them. And so Casey and that kid at Harvest and... Sorry. I lost it.
That's more sense than I can make of it.
They're sad. It's all really sad.
You ready to go again, Angus?
Yeah, sorry.
Wait, everybody shut up.
What?
Shh, I thought I...
Oh, shit. No! Oh, damn! Fucking run. Fucking get the fuck out. Oh, no.
Holy shit!
Is everyone okay?
May! Are you okay? May! Say something! May?
Got you. gone now. Shit. How are we gonna get out of here? Shh. Give her a minute.
I feel air coming in from somewhere. So we're not gonna suffocate.
Okay, well, that's a relief. How do you...
I was a scout, Greg. I was a scout.
Hey, Angus.
Yeah?
I love you.
Oh.
Welcome back, May. You okay? Better now that I almost got murdered.
Again. Which is weird.
That was like the third time in 2 days? Third time's a charm.
Guys, the air is coming from back here.
Alright, I'm up. You sure? Yeah. I think I can walk at least. It's
boarded up. Long time ago.
Can we get through?
Let's find out. I love how the color of the text lets me know who's talking. It's just so much clarity in such a simple little detail, you know?
Let's get out of here.
Yeah, Angus didn't love Greg back. Did you notice?
Did you notice?
Hands in the air. Oh. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Yep, that's some fresh air, all right. And water.
Dude, that's amazing. You can smell water?
Hopefully it's not a river. Cave rivers, death traps.
Mine river. We're in a mine.
Right. Hey, I can run again. Yay!
I can see the bottom.
I don't think we're gonna die in 1 foot of water.
Right.
Right. I mean... Whoa! Oh, fuck. Well... I died in 1 foot of water.
I know what you are now. I think I knew before, but... You know, after I sent that kid to the hospital years ago, he said I had an anger problem. But that's not true. I was angry because of something else. Something I'd lost. Trying so hard since not to be angry. Got me all defenseless. I lost more and more and more. That's not getting better. I want to be angry. When I ran home from college on the bus, I had this dream. Maybe I saw it out the window. Last leaf on the tree, finally blown off. I'm so scared all the time. And the fear hurts. Feeling like everything is over. It was over long before I got here. So long, hiding. Trying to outrun this. I get it. This won't stop until I die. But when I die, I want it to hurt. When my friends leave, when I have to let go, when this entire town is wiped off the map, I want it to hurt. Bad. I want to lose. I want to get beaten up. I want to hold on until I'm thrown off and everything ends. And you know what? Until that happens, I want to hope again. And I want it to hurt. Because that means it meant something. It means I am something, at least. Pretty amazing to be something, at least. You know I can't understand you, right? Oh, shut up already. I know this won't save me in the end. But I don't need it to save me forever. I just need it to save me now. So if you're gonna kill me right here, then do it. If not... Dude, what if the credits rolled? Holy shit. That'd be such a mindfuck. May! Dude, you okay?
Whoa.
You got all sleepwalky there for a sec. I can read, really.
You want me to carry you?
No, I think I'm good. I'm just very, very tired. Yeah, I feel you, May. Hang here for a bit if you need to. We're safe.
Uh-huh. Hey, there's light over here.
Did you smell that?
I bet he did.
Let's go back in the hole. Victory lap!
Give me death. Aww.
Elder gods speak in wingdings. Yeah, it turns out. Huh. What a plot twist.
What is this? Might be a vent or something. Keep the miners from suffocating way back when. Looks old enough, at least.
Hmm? Brochure.
Hello!
Or, hello! We're down here! Don't ask us why, please. Excuse me. All the raspy voices are getting to me, guys.
Could get lucky and someone's out here in the woods at night.
Oh, he got the words mixed up there. It should be, you know. I can try to make it out.
No, I can, like... Okay, yeah, are you up for this?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm like all hyper now. Like dolphins.
Hyper like dolphins?
No, like when your body is like, oh, whoa, I almost died, and you get all hyper because you're filled with dolphins. Okay, I'm seriously confused. Are you okay, May?
Endorphins.
Oh, okay.
There, thank you, those...
Okay, well, ride those dolphins up out of here.
That's assuming I can even do this.
We'll watch.
Okay. Yeah. Can't talk to any of them before I do it? Okay. All hyper and shit.
Yeah. Full of dolphins. Look at me, I'm a dolphin. I'm beautiful and cute. Look at me. Look at me, I'm Mr. Dolphin.
Oh. Just as the music was building up to you, that was really nice. We should have made that well twice as long. This place. Huh. Hey, May.
Germ?
Yeah. What are you doing out here?
I live right up the hill. I heard Greg yelling.
We were all stuck down there. I actually don't recognize the well.
You were at the bottom of the old well in my backyard.
It's been a really bad night.
Sounds like it.
Got any rope or something?
Yeah.
Can you go get it?
Hey, May.
Yeah?
Was that Germ?
Yeah, he's getting some rope.
What is he doing out here?
He lives here.
In the woods?
Trying my best to do a distant voice.
My entire body hurts. That was a long way. I brought some sodas.
You're the best, Germ.
You need the sugar and caffeine.
I want the Germ story. Give me the Germ DLC, like, right now. I want it. Oh, anyone else want to get far away from this well?
Yep.
Germ, can you, like, I don't know, seal up this well? Kill all those people? I guess they might have already died from the tunnel collapsing.
I got dynamite.
What?
Yeah, I mean, I can get some.
How big an explosion is that?
I mean, not small.
Okay, that works.
Thanks, Germ.
Yeah, thanks, buddy.
Okay. Bye, guys.
They had a cutscene for Germ, but it was cut and left in the game.
What?
It was cut and left in the game? Is it like in the extras menu or something?
There goes a weird, weird guy. He saved our lives.
Germ is good. Germ's a good man. I want the Germ DLC.
It strikes me that we just murdered all those dudes down there. How do you figure? Well, I mean, the elevator's broken and we caused a cave-in.
That was self-defense.
I guess, but we did cause the deaths of like a dozen guys. No, no, no. They're all still alive down there. Oh, God. Yeah. Jeez.
Well, we're blameless. They attacked us.
One of them attacked us. So we're worrying about, like... It's morally gray. We're not murderers. Like, if we'd had a choice, we wouldn't have done it.
I would have.
Damn. Angus.
What? They, like, killed people. They were trying to get us to kill people. Screw them. I don't even believe in hell, and I hope they all go straight there.
Jeez, Angus.
Well, that's what I think, at least.
Just like that trolley thing.
What trolley thing?
Okay, I'll explain it if we keep walking.
Damn, Angus, that was so dark. That blank expression.
Germ is you. Oh, beagle bark. Hey, guys. Are you there? Anyone?
Last chance to play Demon Tower.
Okay, I'm gonna type anyway. Hard for me to say anything smart about what the hell even just happened. Easier for me to get it all out there. I need to talk. Even if you jerks are off doing whatever. None of us asked for any of this. It didn't happen to us because we're, like, special. You can work as hard as you want, but the universe is gonna keep doing what it does. And I don't think any of us deserved all this. This is all stuff that started long before we were born. It's all like moving so fast, and you're dropped into it, and you're just trying to grab onto something. All of you are what kept me from floating off tonight. Also, you kinda killed that guy to save me. Don't think I didn't appreciate that. LOL. I don't know if I'm ever gonna understand what all just happened. I hope it stopped. I just feel right now like all I want to do is wrap my arms around all of you. Not just because I love you, but to keep you all together with me. Wrap up into a ball and no one can hurt us. Sorry, I'm rambling. Germ, buddy. Germ, you don't even use Messenger. Guess I'm just typing at you wherever you're at. Germ MVP. B, you're definitely something. I'm so sorry about all you've gone through. I don't even understand all your problems, but if I could fix them, I'd fix all of it. And I'd buy the tools to do it from your store. Or, like, borrow them, at least. A better friend would buy, but I'm what you got. And I'm glad. Yep, there it is. Now I'm just gonna erase all that. Oh shit. Haha, guys, I was just kidding about all that. I'm really tired. I don't know what I'm saying. Log off, May. Log off. She sent it by accident. Yep, I want the Germ DLC. I want it. I want it so bad. Oh, I've never wanted any DLC like the Germ DLC. Yeah, I'm awake. Man, so many questions, though. Like, did the cult just live in the mines? How did they sustain themselves? There are so many of them. Are they just townspeople? Are people going to notice just the missing townsfolk? Like, holy shit, 12 of us just disappeared. You know? Like, so many questions. I guess maybe the epilogue will answer some of it. Hey, May. You okay this morning? I'm not opening the pickaxe today. Greg informs me we're doing band practice, though. Yeah! I'll see you there.
Hey, man. Nice messages last night. I mean, like, really? You massive dork. Band practice today. Because I feel like we need to do something normal. I'm at the Snalkin. Hope you're feeling okay. Sincerely, Gregory.
Yeah, they were just townspeople. But they hide their identities. Yeah, they're all just gonna be gone.
There's one guy missing in town, but he's gone because he moved, not because he's part of the cult. So, oh, wow. So none of the people in the cult are people that you met in town? That's kind of weird. You'd think there'd at least be some overlap. I'll check the journal. Don't worry. It's good to be alive this morning, that's all. There's dialogue. Oh, epilogue. Stars. There's dialogue at that section that talks about it, but I think KY didn't get it. Yeah, I must have missed something. Sometimes I'm so... Oh, you mean didn't get the dialogue? Yeah, I don't know. God, it's us. It's just us. Home and us. I don't know what this feeling is, but I'm not gonna cry today. Hello, clock. Hey, hey, granddad's clock. Hey, granddad. Oh. Yeah, I can still triple jump. Dude, if Aunt Molly was part of the cult, I would be so sad. Hey, Burb. We're gonna eat you for Thanksgiving, Burb. May, honey, is that you? Yeah. I'm back in the kitchen, if you want to talk. And then I just left the house. How mad would you be at me, chat? Hey, sweetie. Hey, Mom. How are you feeling? Good enough to jump up here. Can you do me a favor and stay home tonight? Sure, Mom. Why? Ben, you're an adult, and you can do whatever you want, but you do live here, and you are still my baby. Aw, Mom. We need to come up with some ground rules, just because, honey, you could have died the other night. Then you just left to hang out with your friends? I'm so sorry, Mom. Sweetie, what's going on with you? I've had a really tough year, Mom. Hun, you've had a tough week. We all have. Yeah, but what happened at school, hun? I don't care what it is, just please tell me. Are you working today? No, me and your father are both off today. I'll be around tonight. We can talk about it then? Sure. We can make breakfast for dinner, just like we used to. Dad can flip the pancakes in the air. Yeah, sure. Why not? Are you going out today? Yeah. Can you please stay in the house, in the town, close? Yeah, Mom. I think they're getting some of the longest night decorations out. Oh, wow. Calling for some snow, too. That went fast. What did? The fall. Always does, hon. Okay. Well, I'm off. I love you, sweetie. I love you too, Mom. Hey, let me scroll up and read a little bit of this chat. Because I missed some things here. I will check the journal. I will check it. Don't worry. I've been thinking about Aunt Mallcop being part of the cult. It would make sense that she and whoever went to check on the woods beyond the fence didn't cover up the kidnapping the kid. Yeah, that's true. It's weird that they wouldn't look into that missing arm much, you know? I'm getting close to the end of the game, but there is a whole lot of content he missed intentionally or otherwise. So if you're curious about it, I really recommend getting this game yourself and doing your own playthrough. Yeah, there's a lot to this, like, to the point where I'm contemplating playing again, but doing all of Greg's stuff. Really, guys, if you've enjoyed this stream, pick this up yourself. You really should. Here, I'll link it to you. I feel the developers of this did a really phenomenal job. I like this game a lot. It'll give you lots of feels, and I think you will get... You will get some value out of it no matter what your background is. I think there's something there for everybody. So, I just linked it for you. Let's see. There was something else I was going to say. Oh, May's mom is just like my mom, where the whole, with the whole, you know, you'll always be my baby thing. Like, that's something my mom literally says to me when I go and visit her. Like, she'll ask if, like, I'm okay, and is there anything I can do for you? Do you feel sick? Can I get you medicine? Is there anything I can do? Can I get you anything? it get you anything? It's like, Mom, I'm fine. Really, I am. She's like, no, I know, you're just still my baby. And the thing is, I will. I'll always be your baby, even though I'm 28. So that's a mom thing, you know? It's kind of sweet. And seeing it in this game, I don't know, it warms my heart. Because it's like, yeah, that's me and my mom. Are you still reading the same book? Oh no, this is a different one. This one's about people who died in the mines around here. Oh, cool. Yeah, it's very interesting. It's got some old songs. Want to hear one? Sure. Far from here, the ocean's roaring far away across the din. I hear the Lord I call their children, bringing in, bringing in. I'll see you walking through the barley. We'll find each other, friend and kin. I hear the Lord I call their children, bring them in, bring them in. Tarry with me for a moment. Talk the places we have been. The Lord will call us both to heaven. Bring him in, bring him in. That's nice. It is nice. Yep. Nice song, Mom. Oops, it's not done. I loved this song as a kid. Oh, that's an actual song. I'd never heard of it. So... let's see. Some of the stuff in this game applies to me even though I'm not from a Rust Belt town. I've lived in a bunch of places from a small capital of a state to a rich ass, like snobby ass white suburb to a buttfuck nowhere town in Pennsylvania, which is probably where I got most of my identification with this game. To inside cities. I've just lived in all sorts of places. So. I'm so relieved Dad was not in a cult. Yeah. Sam Reyes is just too good. Aw. Yeah, there's a lot for you, even if you didn't live in one of these towns, you know. Hey, Dad. No work today? I told you, Bob, I told Bob to shove it. Really? Nope. You okay? Yeah, I'll be fine. Not gonna sugarcoat it. I hate my job. Oh, Dad, why? I have mined, I made glass, I've done a heap of other stuff. But this place, they just don't respect you for working. They don't? Just job's supposed to pay you enough to live. Job's supposed to let you provide for your family. Job's supposed to have regular hours. Boss's supposed to respect you. Worker's supposed to be able to talk. Worker's supposed to be able to have a life. Worker's supposed to be able to live. Your mom always had to work, but I want to give you and her your time. Give her and you your time. I wanted her to have hobbies, enough time and money to do them. That's what made me happy. Now I just work so I can keep our health insurance and hold on to the house. Try to at least. Is there anything I can do? I mean, we do need a union. It's just easier to say it than get it done. Unions were always there in the mines and the factory, at least for a while. But here, I got something for you. Guy out of the basement. How'd you get in the basement? Door in the crawl space? That's spooky. So what I got is a tooth.
A what?
Do you know what this tooth is?
No.
Really?
You sure?
Yeah, Granddad must have had it from the old days.
May.
Thank you. Wow, looks bright and new. Look, they just pulled it out of his skull yesterday. You show that to your boss and tell him to eat shit. May. Sorry.
I'll just keep it here with me.
Sure thing.
May.
Yeah?
You come down and pick it with us if we walk out.
I'll breathe fire, Dad.
Love you, kid.
Be back later, Dad.
Oh.
At least the dad is not in the cult. This game really spoke to me. I finished a couple days ago and it was pretty powerful. From May's mental illness to the old mining town problems, even to the cosmic horror. The cosmic horror in your town?
Oh.
everything hit all the right notes for me because I either experienced it myself or read about it when I was younger, like May's ghost stories. That's touching. Hi, Justice Grimstoner. I'm glad that you shared in chat. I want everyone to share what this game meant to them. I'll read all of it. This game is wonderful. Yeah. What are you doing out here, by the way? Get an early start. Our longest night's light plan. Gotta dig them out of the closet. See if they even still work. Can I help put them up? We'll see. You're a small fry. Dad. Dum 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 dum. What this game meant to me, it was good. Yeah, that's all you have to get out of it. Yeah. As a psychology major, I'm interested in what you guys think her diagnosis may be. I have no clue. I'm not fit to, to diagnose. Hey, May. Sup, Selmers. You okay? After the whole, like, head injury thing? Yeah, I'm alright. Headache is all. I got some migraine meds if you need it. Nah, it's not a migraine, and those things make me have to pee. It's the caffeine. If you ever take pills that make you pee, it's the caffeine. I didn't know that. Used to work at the pharmacy. Alright. Well, if I ever have a headache or need to pee, I'll come by. Anytime, neighbor. Yeah. The part of the game that spoke to me the most is probably Greg and Angus's story, since growing up gay in a southern suburb isn't all too different to their situation. Man, probably worse than their situation. But, hey, you're still alive, and it's okay to be you, and that's what matters. I don't talk to this person. They were kind of an asshole at the beginning of the game, so I kind of don't care about them. Yeah, I think I can make it up there from here. Oh, let's check the notebook before I forget. Start at the beginning. Okay, no. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, shit. Can I just go back? Thank you. Okay. Alright. Let's see if there's anything else new. Eels. Dad looks older. Still funny, though. Meats. Big skeleton. Thought. Aunt Mallcop is planning to kill me. Might actually be true. Greg rules, okay. B. Beatrice Santello. Maybe. Oh. Die anywhere else. Weird autumn. Gregory's pizza scale. Too fancy? Good as hell. Avoid. Greg rules, okay. Arm tattoo. Severed. Army jacket. On sidewalk. Angus. Germ? Thought. Become a fire ghost and yell at people. It really is we are still here. Man. F the cops. Thought. Never drink again or go in public.
Blah blah, dumb shit.
Everything feels bad. Ta-da, it's Selmers, a good poet. Thought. If I die, Selmer should write a poem about it. Mysterious tooth. Thor. Castus. Hello, B. Did you get my texts? Thought. Nuke Possum Springs. Honey, I'm home. Bandit Queens of the Fort Lucen Mall. You know, there's a Decemberist song called Bandit Queen that's really good, about falling in love with a master bandit. It's pretty great. Pastor K. I freaking died tonight. Greg rules, okay? Sterling. Simone. Big Snake. Gramercy. Ham Panther Dinner. Fight. How did I mess that up? I wanted to help. I'm garbage at football. I'm garbage. Football. Smash. Greg rules, okay? Halloween. Harfist. There's the murderer. And the big black hole. So, I mean, she did have actual premonitions of this horror, which is interesting. I connected a lot with this game. I don't live in a small town like this one, but the mental illness and college problems May went through hit home. Her mom acts like my mom. She always asks what's wrong. Hopefully, I will tell her one day, too. Oh. If I was 14, I would have found a way to print out Selmer's poem and tape it to my bedroom wall.
Oh.
Just like me and I was 10 with Will Smith songs. The part of the game that spoke to me... Oh, I reread that. Baze being stuck in the town definitely spoke to me. Sometimes I wonder if I'll be able to leave my hometown, especially with how hard it is to find work around here. Yeah, it's tough. It's tough. Dead. Skull hole. Little Joe's dang skull. Dang heckin' skull. Is this why his spirit wanders? Must he be avenged? Saw him. Kingdom of Loathing, Adina. Hella birds. Bombshell. Mayday, BB. Stuck together, don't suck together. That's great. I'm gonna get that whole page tattooed on my back. Thought, Angus is psychic, but his hat blocks it. No clues, but Angus saw him too. There's the hole again. And the shapes. All the shapes. Hmm. So the question is the hole objectively real? Or is it just a crazy cult that's convinced the hole is real? That there's an actual monster? I gotta go see saxophone person. Saxophone. Saxophone. Oh wait, it's not this screen, it's the next one. Ooh. Should start doing my own laundry. Sometime. Okay. The Selmer's poem at the library, yeah. That was really good. I managed to get perfects on Die Anywhere Else in Weird Autumn, but Pumpkin Man eludes me still. Yeah, if that was the last song I did, that was a rough one. Bet Saxophone Lady was cultist. No, that would break my heart. And I have a feeling that the cultists are mostly, you know, blue-collar workers. Saxophone Lady is just a musician. Just a musician. Yeah, this didn't change as much as I was hoping it would. Like, it didn't update as the game went on too much. Oh, Mr. Chazakov, good call. I gotta go back and see him. To see everybody. Maybe everyone's gonna go see May's band play. That would make me happy. Actually, that's... Wait, no. I'll go up here. Rip Casey. Yeah, man. I was convinced he was gonna show up at some point. I feel like some of the old cultists or the old people who patrol the city getting mad. Yeah, probably. And the janitor, almost certainly a cultist. Like, it's almost implied that the janitor is the psychotic tall one that was trying to kill May, personally. I don't know. Hey, May. Hey, Mr. Chazakov. Got any more dusk stars we can look at? One more. Yeah. Maybe May will be up there now. Pretty sure janitor is like God. Yeah, he was there at the very beginning of the game. He's like the big spoiler person in Persona 4, you know. The very, very final true boss. Found it. Let's consult the guide. The Fire Maker. Fire Maker? A wanderer in the cold and dark. One sec, guys. Okay. I think the janitor is the exact opposite of the cult. I feel the janitor is more of an angelic figure because he's always just conveniently there. Yeah, never mind. For light and warmth. Sounds festive. Sounds like survival. Hmm. The star makes me want to cry. Crying on my roof? Do you wish to talk about it? No, it's fine. Is it a happy cry or a sad cry? I don't know. I don't have great words for it. It is okay. Sometimes too many words. Yeah. Thank you for this. Thank you for joining me. I think we have discovered them all? Well, we didn't really discover them, right? I mean, someone else already saw them and named them. I wrote a whole bunch of stuff about them. And we just, like, found what they made for us. Is that not a discovery? Not really. Maybe not in the historical sense. We did not create the stars, or name them. But we had these autumn afternoons and found them together. Isn't that something? Something, something, something. My granddad said something like that once. Something about a story having really happened because hearing it happen to you. That's nice. It's not bad. Yeah, we found them all. I can't really do a Polish accent, so... Yeah, we did it. Achievement unlocked Dusk Stargazer. Woo. So what now? Supermoon is coming. What is that? A giant moon! Oh, that does sound super. You must come meet me when it happens. It will be late at night. There will be others on their roofs. You come, I will make the hot chocolate. What a time! That sounds great! I want to see a supermoon! Plan on it. See you later, Mr. Trazikov. See you soon, Stargazer. Yeah. Erskine. Yeah, I've seen a supermoon or two. It's pretty much just a giant moon. Just like the game said. Hey, there's another cat driving. He says he has owed the trees more than once. Huh. That mysterious guardian janitor. When winter come and water freeze, here the fish can be at ease. The tunnel is not flooded ruin. It's a home, a place for doing. Sure, that works. Please go away. Oh, fine. The punk-ass teens gonna be down here? No. Oh, they are. Haha. Hey, you guys. Yeah? Stay safe, alright? Wow, thanks, Mom. Are you our new mom? Apparently. Life, man. It goes. Slowly. Nah, dude. Nah. Alright. I love May's triple jump sounds. They're pretty great. I missed the entire Rat Babies side plot. What? Rat Babies. These streams are fucking up my sleep schedule, but it's worth it. It's almost over, man. Hang in there. Hey, Hootie. I never got to talk to you much, but I just wanted to say you meant a lot to me during these games. Be able to talk to you. I also gotta make it on the roof from here at some point. Did I already miss the spot where I can do that? Hey, it's the janitor. Hey, it's you. Yep. For now, at least. You know, I never got your name. I'm the janitor. I clean up, do fix-its. Whatever needs done. Oh, okay. So, what's it like been being home again? Things like you remember? No. I don't know. I don't even remember today. Sounds like you've been through something. How'd you know? Call it experience. I swear some mornings I feel every bit as old as these trees. You know, something big did happen. I feel like I should have woken up today and, like, have learned something, but I don't know if I learned anything, really. Well, in my experience, the big things don't teach you anything, but they make you something. And sometimes you gotta wait a while and see what come of it. Huh. Well, done an honest day's work. Quitting time. Smelter's game tonight. See you around. Not if I see you first, May. Haha. Yeah, that's what I was going for, Krunk. Wait, how'd you know my name? Whoa! Janitor, Mr. Janitor, Lord Janitor, Bob Janitor. Thought I could get a job as a janitor and really enjoy it. Yeah, that's not such a bad job. Fixing things up, doing clean things, making things look nice. Getting paid. doesn't sound so terrible. Why is there such a negative stigma on janitors, really? Could be so much worse. Hey, Bubby. Hey, you okay? Hey, I heard you were like in the hospital or something. Haha, yeah. What for? Fell into a ravine while running through the woods at night. Why? Chased by a death cult of conservative uncles. Alright, you don't have to tell me. You want to hang out sometime? Isn't that what we're doing? I mean, like, we could watch horror movies. You could meet my sister. She's, like, almost your age. What's her name? I probably know her from school. Stevie Myers, but you don't know her. She beat up someone and had to go to a different school. Oh, cool. We might get along. Probably. She's mean sometimes, but she's cool. Sounds good. I gotta get going. It's been a weird past couple of days. Weird's good. I guess weird's just what happens. See you around. Later, kid. Later, killer. Kitty. Yeah. Won't be able to climb this soon, once it gets icy. Enjoy it while the weather lasts, May. The highest spot in town. I found it. Yeah. I'm gonna reach out a little bit, give me a sec. Janitor's pretty much that drifter from the Big Lebowski. Doesn't contribute much to the plot, but shows up and says memorable lines. I've actually never seen the Big Lebowski. Fucking get that. The only negative I've seen from a janitor is them getting angry when I accidentally call him a janitor. I prefer to be called a custodian. Dude, I wouldn't mind. I'd be like, whatever, it's this way. What they are, so. Yeah, it took me a while to find Lori. Next time, you should definitely talk to Lori every day. She's the best. Yeah, I like Lori. Fuck. Actually. No, well, do I need to? Hang on, we missed the room. At least I think we did. Maybe, I don't know. Where was the saxophone room again? Shit. Whoa. What? Dude, all this stuff that I hadn't found before. What is this? Wow, so this is where his stuff ended up. I remember the spring parade. It was so much fun. Till the year that mallard pea blooming grow snapped his tether and ran over Chris Evans. That was a hard bubble to read. Then they canceled the parade. I'm already too late? As in I can't go do her dialogue? They couldn't cage Mallard. Mallard needed to be free. Neither ropes nor the poor legs of Chris Evans could hold him back. I wonder what happened to both of them. After the parade got canned, there wasn't much going on in the spring. We still did that Easter basket blessing at the church. And ate special pretzels. We didn't bother to bless those. Profane pretzels. Oh my god, these flowers are fake as hell. Mallard deserves a better memorial. Plastic flowers are like super depressing for some reason. Dead flowers are less depressing than plastic ones. What's gonna happen to all this? I guess it's just gonna sit here till someone gets around to throwing it all out. I should, like, steal the good stuff. See what Mom and Dad think. I'm sure they'll love it. Redecorate the living room. Yeah, Chris Evans is dead. Bummer. Poor Captain America. I had a classmate who is named, oh, shit. Now I can't remember her name, but I know an easy way to find it. Oh, Amy Lee was her name. And in band, she was a trumpet player. And our band director would always say, "So, how's that Evanescence thing working out for you? Still pretty good?" Because apparently that was Evanescence Lady's name. He would make that joke at least once or twice a month, so you'd hear it pretty regularly. And every time she was like, "Pretty good." That Evanescence thing. Oh my god. Mallard, what have they done to you? Oh no, Mallard forever. Mallard P. Bloomingrow. One of my absolute favorite things when I was a kid. Proudest of the spring parade floats. Dude, this is a tomb. This is Mallard's tomb. This song is grooving as shit. Mallard. Dear dead Mallard. You were my favorite anything when I was a kid. I ran to the spring parade to see you. You were like a big beaky dinosaur. Mallard, you're still amazing forever. Oh, Mallard. Probably left here by the Possum Springs Chamber of Commerce. Forgotten. But I found you, and I know you're here, and still a springtime terror. I'll keep you a secret, Mallard, but I'll visit. What's going on? Mallard, you're pregnant! It's one of those God things. Like when you have a baby because God. Holy crap, you're the cutest vermin. Who's the best vermin? You are! You look so hungry. Is that why you're, not doing anything? I'll come back with food. Don't die. Pat, pat. Yeah. You want to hear the most annoying sound in the world? Pretty good. It's locked. What the hell? Is that a fire hazard? That's a fire hazard. No, seriously. Is this thing clearly marked as something is not? Coming back for you, exit door. And we're gonna have a little chat with my boot. Worst exit, easily. This song is so good. I just want to sit here and listen to this one for a while. I'm gonna take a nap. Just enjoy this music for an hour. Be right back. Get them food from the subway and the pretzel place, really. What the hell, the random generation thing? Put mouse in it with a 5. So I can get food from the subway. Someone said it was too late to go see the saxophone lady. Is that true? I heard the new game Paradigm. I think so. Is that that adventure game? That point-and-click adventure? The really weird art style? Or am I thinking of something else? Fuck, I can't get up there. There we go. Sadie is inaccessible today. Oh no. Oh, that's a bummer. Alright, let me go get food for the rats. If you talk to Sadie and Salim every day, they'd be playing together in Subway. Aww. Yeah, I'm gonna steal that pretzel. Do some crimes. Okay, May. You're only gonna get one shot at this. Just gotta freeze when he looks over. Even if you're holding a pretzel. No movement. Simple psychology. You've done this before. You've still got it. Easy. Okay, go. I am the Bandit Queen. Yeah. I was wondering why the game kept giving me a prompt at the rat. Or not the rat, at the pretzel, I mean. And now I know. Damn. No, I missed several days with Sadie. I didn't find her until pretty late in my run, so.
Okay, let's go feed the rats. And then I'll get on with the epilogue. Is missing? I don't know. Not that I've noticed. Other than Sadie, I guess. But I think she's just inaccessible. Alright, my little miracle rats. Time to eat! Gotcha. Yeah. Wow, you're hungry. Very hungry. Guess I'm your mom now? I don't know if I'm ready to be a mom. Aww. Achievement unlocked, Mother of Vermin. Nice. That was so worth it. Actually, tell you what.
Tell you what?
I'm gonna go use the bathroom real quick. And while I do, you can enjoy one of the best songs in the game. Sound good? Okay. I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. Did I miss anything? Smelter Gator is missing, as we'll see. If we talked to him every day, we'd see that he's moving out, so he's not a cultist. Aw. Maybe it's, like, dynamic. Like, those who you didn't talk to are the ones that end up being cultists, because you don't care about them, and because they don't appear in the final day. That's what I think. Oh, and I just realized that snow is falling a little bit. I totally didn't catch that earlier. Yeah, High Justice. I really loved this game a lot, too. I think that during the course of this stream, I've imparted more about my childhood and my upbringing. And, my adolescence and my feelings and any other stream that I can think of. I really opened up to you guys a couple times. Threw myself out there. Super vulnerable. Not even giving a fuck. And everyone just hung with me anyway, so thank you guys so much. Holy crap! A taco place?
This is the best thing that's happened in this town since... got rid of all those snakes in the diner? Since we got the internet. The owners were religious. They called in a preacher from one of the holiness camps up in the hills. And he got in there and yelled at the snakes to leave. The next day after he died, they just set traps. Nobody knows where they came from or why they moved in. But they're long gone now. God, life moves on, huh? Well, one of the programmers did Aquaria, which was pretty complicated, but... oh my god, they deliver! I'm gonna eat the shit out of some tacos. I mean, yeah, I guess this game didn't take too complex programming, but... I'm not sure what I was trying to get at that with. I don't know why I keep wanting to go in here. I just keep seeing the icon, and there's nothing. We're all secretly conniving behind you and talking about how big a nerd you are for opening up to us. That's what Vinny had for dinner tonight. You know what Vinny had for dinner. Alec did music and art. He didn't do any of the programming? I thought he did programming and music, and I thought that, I don't know who, Derek Yu is a programmer for Aquaria, oh, I'm sure. So you're a taco dude now? I mean, I was hired to be a taco artisan, but I guess that means holding this sign out in the snow. It's not really snowing that hard. It's snowing, there's snow in the sky falling. How are the tacos here? Good. I like tacos. There is not one person on God's earth who doesn't love tacos. Bad news. My ex hates tacos. Good news. They're now your ex. Have fun with the tacos. Hippies. Yeah, I know the programmers' names, but I don't know all their roles other than the fact that Alec Holoka did the music. There's also, I think, Bethany Hockenberry and Scott Benson, and I don't know who did what, but they did a great job. Taco Buck, dine in, dine out. We deliver. Please tip your delivery persons. Best tacos in all this general region, pretty sure. Been missing the pizza place? Why not try a pizza taco? Oh wow, that sounds amazing. Watching your health? Try out all lettuce taco. No, I refuse. Get out of here, kid, I'm a working. I think based on the writing, I bet Scott did a lot of the writing, because a lot of the writing is like how he tweets. I actually didn't get the OST yet. I think I'm going to, though. Actually, I want to read this sign. Taco artisans, delivery drivers, all shifts, $8 per hour. Is Chipotle considered an artisan shop? Who are you? Haven't you seen me around? No. Well, I've noticed you. It's not weird or anything. A bit cold for staying outside, isn't it? Someone's gotta stand here. Hey, you Smeltz's fan? Yeah. Oh, really? Yeah. Go Smeltz's? Go Smeltz's. Go Smeltz's. His buddy was a cultist. You know, I probably missed a whole bunch up here too. Oh, okay. I thought that was a platform. Oh well. Dub Bears. No, it's clearly a Steelers reference. He's not a cultist. He just moved away. Oh, okay. Yeah, you guys talked about that. Alright, let's go see Germ. I like May's face when she's falling in the falling animation. The way her eyes kind of fold up. Oh, nothing over here. Why is my bark? It kind of sounds like a bark, doesn't it?
I forgot I got the OST with my Kickstarter pledge, and it's the best gift my past me gave myself. Nice. Yeah, it's tough with OSTs on the Kickstarter pledge because you have a pretty good idea of what the game is like, but very rarely do you have an idea of what the music's going to be like, right? So.
Well, look who's alive and well.
Is that a surprise?
Nah, it just seems, like, relevant.
Well, look who's alive and well, you too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You wanna get out of here? Do band practice?
Yeah.
God, this door just does not like to open.
Bet it's worse in the summer. Oh wow, there's a pentagram on this sticker.
I can't read the band name on it.
Cops Driller? I guarantee you it's not Cops Driller. Maybe it's like a German band with a name in English. Sounds like that.
Guten Tag, wie a Cops Driller.
Auf Wiedersehen. Close enough. Where's Greg? Oh yeah, he had to spring Angus from work.
What does that mean?
Zero clue.
Huh.
I'm a little unclear about how both of them still have jobs, since they seem to just up and leave work early a lot.
There's a lot about those two I don't understand.
I think they just plain need each other.
Greg more than Angus, I think.
I don't think Angus would agree. That's because it wouldn't occur to Angus to think otherwise. Because Angus is an extremely nice person. Greg's a nice person!
Oh yeah, he definitely is, but he's also a bratty and irresponsible, and has, like, zero attention span. Greg needs a parent as much as he needs a boyfriend. And he's really lucky Angus is a little bit of both.
Angus thinks Greg, like, saved him.
Listen, I'm not saying he didn't if he thinks so. Angus might also just be attracted to really sincere guys in leather jackets who carry knives. I mean, if I met the right guy, those would all be pluses.
Jeez, you thought this out.
Before you came back, they were the only people I hung out with most of the time. I've had a lot of time to study.
So, like, how are you? I don't even know. I'm still processing.
I'm here, though.
Yeah.
You?
Not great. Had a dream the world was ending.
Might be.
Do you think we're safe?
No idea.
Great feeling.
Yep.
So, like, I'm a little confused about what even happened last night.
Well, there's apparently a death cult of dads. Or was. Who knows if that was all of them.
I can't believe they even exist. Or existed.
Probably take them a few days to die.
Yep.
I don't know. I kind of understand that. Understand them in a weird way.
Really?
It's like a porch light that's on. And there are all these bugs around it. And then the light goes out. There's a hole where the light was. It's like what happened to me way back. Like I was telling you about on the couch last night. Holy crap, that was last night. Seems like two lifetimes ago.
Yeah.
God, I can't even wrap my head around these past 2 weeks.
I think that's pretty understandable, May.
There were these three weird teens, and they told me I'd see a bunch of pentagrams.
What teens?
The ones we bumped into in the graveyard.
Oh God, those teens.
Anyway, they said if I saw three pentagrams, I'd get some sort of help. I actually saw one at that party we went to, and last night I saw the last one down the tunnel. It made me think. You remember Adina and the frozen lake?
The folktale?
Yeah, sure. That astronomer under the ice or whatever couldn't find a star until after she died?
The ghost star?
Just thinking stars are upside down if you're looking at their reflections.
That's true.
Which is what you'd see if you were a reflection in the ice.
Yeah, I get it. I read the story.
I barely noticed it when we were down there last night, but today, just thinking about that, just feeling like at the end of everything you can hold on to something, or anything. Find the spooky ghost star, put it on a map, and you, have a map? I don't know, I'm hungry and tired, and I feel like I got run over by a train that was carrying other trains. I'm really impressed you got all of that out of teens being weird and spooky. Pattern seekers. What? Something Angus said. We're good at finding patterns. Yeah. It's like a survival thing. Yeah. So, how good is your car? Good how? Like, can it drive real far? May, do you know anything about... What? We should, like, do a road trip. To where? Out west. It gets all flat. That it does. We can go where it's really flat. They sell barbecue. You could see, like, the world's largest pierogi. That's actually not true. Pierogies exist less the further west you go. Or a museum of toy rocket ships. Or a factory where they make pretzels. Or a house that looks like a big chicken. I could... Okay, let's talk about it next year. I'll start planning it now. I thought you couldn't leave home because of your... issue. You're home enough. I mean, if we're trapped here together, we might as well be trapped out there together. I mean, if we're not dead by then, lol. You have a way of making Doom sound like a lot of fun, Mayday. That is actually kind of a gift. Oh, she called me Mayday. God damn this door! I think God already has. There they are. Hey, guys. Sup, nerds? Psh, it's you who are nerds. Yeah, it's you, nerds.
What?
Jeez, we've never been so insulted.
Take it right back, dork.
Fat chance. Hey, Greg, so, I didn't really know Casey.
Yeah.
I just wanted to say I'm really sorry.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Casey was a good one.
Casey was good. Should we, like, tell his parents?
Probably.
What do we tell him?
I don't know. Can we, like, make up something that sounds real?
Oh, what? The truth isn't real enough? No, no, you're right. The truth is insane.
So, like, what do we do?
About Casey?
No, like, in general.
Can we think about this tomorrow? Can we just play a song and get a pizza? I don't think song and pizza is an answer, really.
Can we just be normal for, like, one day?
I don't know how today can possibly feel normal.
When I was down there last night, I, like, made the decision not to die. Or at least not to die without a fight. And the thing down there told me nothing would save me forever.
Wait, it was, like, talking to you?
It's been talking to me for a long time. I just didn't know what it was. But anyway, like, nothing is gonna save us forever. But a lot of things can save us today. That's really pretty, May.
Thanks, I totally made it up. Like, right on the spot last night. I said it before, you're good with Doom.
Doom, Doom, Doom.
So anyway, song and pizza. We earned it by still being alive for another day. That's a decent reason.
Decent.
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 That final scene and the hard cut into the credits with the sudden music kind of reminded me of a Wes Anderson movie. What a great game. I'm sad I don't get to actually play the music part for this last song, but that's okay.
Yeah.
So, here are things I want out of Night in the Woods' future for a blossoming franchise. A, I need Night in the Woods Hot Fuzz mashup art. I need that. I need it frame it on my fucking wall. Second, I need the Germ DLC. I need to know more about Germ and his story. And maybe see a little bit, just a little bit more, wow, I already forgot their name, Garbo and Malloy in my life as well.
That's a whopper.
I had to do it just one more time. Pixel art typeface by Dadako. That guy had a pentagram. Andy Schatz. I actually interviewed that dude on stream. Oh. He is the guy who made Monaco. Our patient. And all the backers that you... How many people in chat backed this on Kickstarter? I know that Jethro Butts did. And there's Rami. He made Nuclear Throne. The Hockenberries and Shades of Central Penna. Yeah, Pennsylvania! Woo! The Monaco guy, what'd he do? He did Monaco. He's working on a new game called Tooth and Tail. It looks really good, too. Oh, the kitty. Garbo said something, they were going to join a cult. I wonder if it's the Black Goat cult. That connection. Never considered that. Achievement unlocked at the end of everything. Shorkel. Yeah. You're from PA too? What part of PA are you from, man? Oh, do I have control over this? I already put my controller down. I do. That's it. Yeah. And Sock Puppet's also from PA. Goddamn. Where are you in PA, Sock Puppet? You're in Southeast? Dude, I was in Southeast PA. Oh, shit. I lived, like, right on the border of PA, Delaware, and Maryland. Like, literally where the three states meet is where I lived. A bit south of Kennett Square. A little bit further south of Westchester. I guess Westchester would be the most notable area that I'm close to. I'm where Bam Margera grew up. Isn't that fucking great? Mm-hmm. What about you, Sock Puppet? Oh, all the PA guys. Dude. All I have to say to you, Green Hat, is to savor Wawa while you still have it. Because someday you're going to move to a place without Wawa. And it's going to suck dick. That's all I got to say. Oh, man. Bam who? Yeah, I mean, I guess he is kind of falling out of the limelight, hasn't he? West Kilt Town. Sharkle was in the cult. You're pretty close to Westchester. Oh. You're from Lehigh Valley. Oh, okay. That name is extremely familiar. I think I might have had a marching band show there before. Wait, is Lehigh Valley more in the east or the west? I went to college in West PA, but I mostly, my family lived in East PA, so maybe I just drove near it on the way to college, I don't know, but Lehigh Valley is a very familiar name. Just thinking about Bam today makes me sad. I think he's moving into a better place. Wawa is like a convenience store, you fucking take that back. It is so much more than a convenience store and you just don't fucking get it, okay? That's all I gotta say. Hi Justice says, this stream was pretty fucking exceptional, KY. I've been watching for years, but this is my favorite stream since Dropsy. Oh, thanks, dude. I think this game has been more charming. The most charming game I've played since Dropsy. So. Thanks for the really cool game and really cool talks. Peace. See you later, Hi Justice. Thanks for tuning in, dude. It was nice seeing you. And, you know, it really makes me happy that this game seem to really touch as many people like it touched me. That brings me so much joy. This is one of the few games where I played it for the first time, and then I was getting tweets and Twitch messages, and pretty much every orifice I was getting requests for to continue this game. So that doesn't really happen too much. So when it does happen, I know it's definitely something special. So thank you, guys. Thank you. I'm so sick of open world games. Absolutely awful pacing. Well, Zelda did it really well. Okay, anyway, I'm gonna head out. I have an eye doctor appointment in the morning. Let's check the art before we go. See if there's any new art. Give me just a sec. The game pauses when I click out of the window, so there's actually one new art that I have not shown. Let me pull it up for you. Give me a moment. This one is from Dragon Corrin. Just a nice little Night in the Woods art, and everybody's naked. And there I am, on the right too. Bea kind of looks, she looks like a dragon. I don't know, I thought more of a dragon when I saw this art. Pretty good art. Thank you so much for that, Dragon Corrin, for that very nice art. Alrighty, it's been fun, everybody, but I'm rambling. I'm tired. I'm ready for sleep. So I'm going to go sleep. That's going to be it. I will catch you next time with some Zelda, maybe some Nier in the future. I'm still debating if I want to replay through the first game before I go and play Nier Automata. So haven't decided. Plus some other things coming up. I haven't decided if I'm going to stream Persona 5 or if I'm going to do it off stream or what's going on with that, because that's probably a 60-hour game. I have a tough time committing to really long games on stream. Yeah, this was rad. This was super rad. Yeah. Alright. I'm peacing out. I hope y'all have a great evening. Tomorrow, we're going to be doing some D&D. Speaking of the art that's on the screen right now, Brisket is my paladin corgi, and so that will be a lot of fun. Rev is playing as a senile wizard named Gerald. He's a wizard! And then Jen is playing an incarnation of her previous character, Wenho. And Imakuni is playing as a tiefling, whatever that is. Apparently it's some really infamous creature in the D&D-verse, but that means nothing to me, so there you go, for those who are into D&D. Tune in on Rev's channel, Rev Scarecrow, if you're not already. Let me shout him out. This is going to start... Rev Scarecrow... This is going to start at 8 p.m. Central Standard, so that's 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific, I believe. That would be 1, 2, 3, 2 a.m. GMT or so-ish. So, all right, guys, I'm peacing out. I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching. You have a good one. Bye-bye.